everybody, welcome back. If you are watching this video, you are probably building a new house and in the process of doing all of that, including your upgrades, which is what this video is going to be about. If you're interested in hearing about structural upgrades, you might want to check out the video right before this one. This video is going to be about visiting the design center and all of the interior upgrades that we made to our new house. So I have everything on my phone, which is what I will be using to go through all of the items. There is a lot, so please bear with me. I hope this video is beneficial because I'm going to talk about the prices, the things that were included, and just our experience overall. So before I jump into this, let me just tell you how it went. We put down our deposit for the lot, and on that day we made all of our structural upgrade decisions. We did add some items on about 2 days later, and then we finalized that. About, I want to say 3 weeks later, 21 days, they gave us a call to schedule an appointment for the design center, and that was about 2 weeks out from that date, I want to say, right around in there. That gave us plenty of time to go to places like Lowe's and Home Depot and price out things such as slow close cabinets and doors, light fixtures, fixtures in the kitchen, the bathrooms, just all of those little things you have to think about. We went and priced them out to see what it would cost us to do it at Lowe's, plus the cost of our time and effort and whether or not we felt we could achieve those things. That way when we went to the design center, we had a better idea of things. Okay, I'm gonna try not to get too crazy because this is so much information, but let me get things open back up. So I want to hear in the comments below, if you've built a house previously, how these prices align with what you experienced before, or maybe you've built multiple homes. I want to know if these prices are in line with it, because we've never built a house from scratch before. So these prices were completely new to us, other than some videos that I've seen previously. Okay, so structural upgrades all said and done. Now these are items that were added to configuration, it says. Starting in the kitchen. We upgraded the cabinets, however, it seems that they have charged us for a cabinet custom layout. I believe that this is because we purchased a different package for appliances that was charged separately, but I believe that having the layout customized is what this fee is for, and it is $2,169. We also upgraded the cabinet color. They had two cabinet colors to choose from. One was like a red cherry wood, the other one was just a darker wood. I decided to go with white cabinets. Something interesting to note here is that I had intended on doing two-tone cabinets, meaning I wanted the bottom cabinets to be navy and the top cabinets to be white. But they told me that the cabinets are actually one structural piece that runs along the back of the wall, so they could not do two different cabinet colors. Who knew, right? So we got the white cabinets, which is level two, and that was $2,160 to upgrade just to that color. We also had to pick an island, and I was a little bit confused about this because we were told it was a level five, and it is billed as a level five in one area and as a level four in another area. It is granite quartz. They said that typically people do pick level five for their countertops. This was $6,350 for the island, and then I do see a charge for $230, which might just be like another piece in the kitchen. I'm not 100% sure. Like I mentioned before, we changed the kitchen to a culinary kitchen, meaning that we wanted the cooktop, an oven below, and then off to the side it'll be the microwave stacked on top of a second oven. That change was $1,010. Okay, we also decided to just upgrade the kitchen faucet. They had a lot of options. We didn't like the standard one, and for the price, we thought it was fair to upgrade, it was $460 for the faucet. I also upgraded the actual sink itself to a stainless steel undermount. I really wanted the white farmhouse sink, and my husband thinks that it looks awful, but we were gonna do it, but we found out that that was $2,500. This sink is $500, and you know, it is what it is, right? Additionally, we wanted the cabinets to go all the way to the ceiling, otherwise they were just gonna cut short, and I feel, not like I really have to have a huge reasoning, but this is going to be our home for a long time, and I just love the look of it going all the way to the ceiling with crown molding. That upgrade was $6,240, which really hurts, but I feel that it's worth it. In the kitchen, they also looped in the soft water system, which is $1,200. That is one item that we did price out at Lowe's, and it was about the same. Okay, I want to go back earlier to where I was talking about the upgrade for $1,010, where it adjusts the kitchen configuration of the actual appliances. That was $1,000. Well, to do the upgrade for the cooktop and the two gas ovens and the microwave, it's actually $3,220 for that. So you really have to watch out if they're charging you to change the configuration, because on top of that, you're also paying for the actual appliances themselves. Okay, so that seems to be everything that's listed in the kitchen. Now we're moving on to the owner's bathroom. The countertop in the bathroom, we decided to do, I don't even know what material it is, but it says the color is platinum. I know it's some sort of natural stone. We were going to do Petrofina, but it was a little bit more costly. This one is $380 just for the countertop in the master bathroom. Okay, we also have the countertop in bathroom 2 for $330, the countertop in bathroom 3 for $210, and the countertop in bathroom 4 for $220. Bathroom 5 has the pedestal sink, which is in the powder room, and that comes standard. All right, a lot of these other fees are kind of crazy and bulk together, so I'm going to do my best to explain the breakdown, but something we were planning on doing was changing out the actual sink faucets and handles themselves, but my husband was not comfortable with doing that in all of the showers, and they don't sell those separately. It's sold as a package. So we picked group 4, which was like somewhere in the middle of all of those packages, and I'm going to list those fees. $1,640, $415, and $130. That's how much everything costs to do that upgrade. Additionally, in the master bathroom, we have that giant shower. And to tile that giant shower, it was $8,703. That's for the tiles on the wall and the rocks on the bottom, the river rock on the bottom. We also raised the cabinets in one bathroom that was $130, and then we upgraded all of the toilets to comfort height, so each one was $100. That totaled out to $500. For flooring, we did laminate in the entire house except for the bedrooms and the hallway. That's $23,204 to do that upgrade. We also upgraded the carpet padding, which was $1,760. We did not upgrade the carpet itself, even though I really wanted to, but it was expensive, so we just went with a standard option for their carpet, and if after a couple of years we want to upgrade at Lowe's, we will do that. We also upgraded we're moving on to other parts of the house, in case you hadn't noticed, right? For the master closet, we upgraded that just a little bit, nothing crazy. That was $2,309. We also decided to get the laundry cabinets over the washer and dryer. That was $1,730. Otherwise, it would have just been a wire rack. Additionally, I purchased a backsplash for the kitchen. That was $2,794, which was a lot cheaper than I thought it was going to be. And let's see, what else do we have left? I think that that might be all of the upgrades. I'm not sure if I'm missing anything, but if I am, I will drop it in the description below. I know that a lot of this was rushed, and I'm definitely going to take some more time in the future to do a retrospective and talk about all of that. But if you have any questions, comments, or advice for us, please leave it in the comments below. Be sure to like, subscribe, and follow me over on Instagram because I do a lot of updates over there. All right, thanks for watching. I will talk to you guys soon. Bye.